إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم تسليمًا كثيرًا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله. Indeed, the most truthful of speech, the best of words are the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. And the best guidance is the guidance of our beloved messenger Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. وشر الأمور محدثاتها. And the worst of affairs are those things we newly invent into this religion of ours. وكل محدثة بدعة. And everything we newly invent into this religion of ours is an innovation. وكل بدعة ضلالة. And every innovation is misguidance and leads astray. وكل ضلالة في النار. Every going astray, every misguidance is in the hellfire. ثم أما بعد. Dear brothers and sisters in Islam, year after year, we have an issue that constantly comes up. And sadly, although it's clearly an innovation that should not be practiced, for a couple reasons. First and foremost, we don't even know if it's the correct date. And second, we were given two Eids to celebrate, Eid al-Adha and Eid al-Fitr. And these are our two occasions of celebration. Celebrating other than them is an innovation. And yearly, the idea, the celebration, the making of a holiday of the Mawlid is something that infests the Muslim masajid across the world. Not just here in the US, but across the world. So we need to look at why this is an innovation, how it's an innovation, why there is no basis for it, and what really loving our Prophet ﷺ is. Look at the ayat and the ahadith first that clarify these positions. قَالَ اللَّهُ وَنَزَّلْنَا عَلَيْكَ الْكِتَابَ تِبْيَانًا لِكُلِّ شَيْءٍ. That Allah said what means, and we were sent down this book, this revelation, as an explanation and an admonition, an exposition for everything. For everything. Everything was mentioned in the book that we need to know. ثُمَّ قَالَ اللَّهُ مَا فَرَّطْنَا فِي الْكِتَابِ مِنْ شَيْءٍ. And Allah said, what means that we have not neglected anything from this book. No guidance, nothing that you need, whether it was at that time or this time or 100 years from now, if the world goes that long. Everything was given in the book that you need for that guidance. ثُمَّ قَالَ اللَّهُ الْيَوْمَ أَكْمَلْتُ لَكُمْ دِينَكُمْ وَأَتْمَمْتُ عَلَيْكُمْ نِعْمَتِي وَرَضِيتُ لَكُمُ الْإِسْلَامَ دِينًا. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He said, what means, this day I have perfected your religion for you and completed my favor upon you and chosen for you al-Islam as your religion. Noting here that Allah said al-Islam, the Islam. The Islam He revealed to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as lived and understood by the Sahaba radiallahu anhum wa ardahum. This is what we were are to be upon. ثُمَّ قَالَ اللَّهُ قُلْ إِن كُنْتُمْ تُحِبُّونَ اللَّهِ فَاتَّبِعُونِي يَحْبِبُكُمُ اللَّهِ وَيَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ ذُنُوبُكُمْ وَاللَّهُ غَفُورٌ رَحِيمٌ. And Allah says what means, say, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to the people, indeed, if you love Allah, then follow me, follow my sunnah, meaning my sunnah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Follow what I give you, stay away from what I prohibit you from, and then Allah will love you. So following the sunnah is tied to earning the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then Allah will forgive you your sins, and Allah is all forgiving, most merciful. ثُمَّ قَالَ اللَّهُ وَمَن يُطِعِ الرَّسُولَ فَقَدْ أَطَاعَ اللَّهُ. And whoever obeys, as Allah said, what means, whoever obeys the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, then this person has obeyed Allah. Therefore, the opposite is true. The one who disobeys Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam or leaves off his sunnah, then this person has disobeyed and left off Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. ثم قال الله وما آتاكم الرسول فخذوه وما نهاكم عنه فانتهوا. And Allah said, what means? Whatever the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam gives you, you take it, you follow it, you implement it, and whatever he prohibits you from, you stay away from it. ثم قال الله وما ينطق عن الهوى إن هو إلا وحي يوحى. And Allah says, what means? And the Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he is not speaking of his own desires, his own whims, his own intellect, his own thoughts. He's speaking what he says, what he speaks is a wahi, it's a revelation revealed to him by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Everything the Prophet ﷺ said and did was wahi, was revelation that Allah promised to protect for all of time. وَقَالَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ مَنْ عَمَلَ عَمَلًا لَيْسَ عَلَيْهِ أَمْرُنَا فَهُوَ رَبْ. رَوَاهُ بُخَارِي وَمُسْلِمْ. And the Prophet ﷺ, he said, what means, whoever does an action not from the actions of ours, not prescribed by Allah or His Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, then it is to be rejected. وقال في رواية من أحدث في أمرنا هذا ما ليس منه فهو رد. And whoever speaks a word, says a thing that has not been from what has been legislated by Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, then it will be rejected. وقال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم لا يؤمن أحدكم حتى لا يؤمن عبد حتى أكون أحب إليه من أهله وماله والناس أجمعين. رواه مسلم. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, no one completely believes, no one achieves complete faith and belief until I, the Messenger of Allah, Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, is more dear and beloved to him or her than his family, even his parents. The Prophet, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, comes above your parents. Then his wealth, and then all of mankind. So if you love the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, then he must be dearer to you and more beloved to you than all the people you know, even your family, even all of your wealth. وَقَالَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ لَا تُطْرُونِي كَمَا أَطْرَتَ النَّصَارَ ابْنَ مَرْيَمْ فَإِنَّمَا أَنَا عَبْدُهُ فَقُولُ عَبْدَ اللَّهِ وَرَسُولُهُ. And the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said in the authentic hadith, do not exaggerate in praising me. Do not exaggerate in honoring me. Do not exaggerate in celebrating me like the Christians have the Son of Mary. By making a big festival, by making a Christmas, by making a festival and Eid out of this, a celebration out of it. For indeed I am the Messenger of Allah, I am the slave of Allah. So call me Allah's slave, Allah's servant, and Allah's Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Ikhwani wa akhwati fillah, this is just a drop in the water of the proofs and the evidences of what truly loving Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam is, what truly honoring the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is. This is just a drop in the water from the proofs and the evidences. Our Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, his Sahaba radiallahu anhum wa ardahum, the four imams, al-a'imma al-arba'a, Imam Abu Hanifa, Imam Malik, Imam al-Shafi'i, Imam Ahmad, rahimahumullah, they were never found to be celebrating other than the two Eids, and definitely not be celebrating the Mawlid, or the birth of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And they were from the best of the generations. كَمَا قَالَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ خَيْرُ النَّاسِ قَرْنِي ثُمَّ الَّذِينَ يَلُونُهُمْ ثُمَّ الَّذِينَ يَلُونُهُمْ. As the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said in the authentic hadith, the best of mankind is my generation, meaning him and his companions radiallahu anhum. ثُمَّ الَّذِينَ يَلُونُهُمْ, then those who follow them, the tabi'een, then those who follow them, the tabi'een. These are the best of mankind. So how do we celebrate his birthday sallallahu alaihi wasallam when we do not value, when we do not cherish, when we do not live the message he came with? How do we do such a thing? When we don't even follow his advice, when we don't follow his warnings, when we don't follow his guidance that he came with, that he struggled for, that he got beaten with, that he got insulted with, that they ridiculed him with, that he stood firm upon, yet in amongst that and his companions radiallahu anhum, when he was surrounded at one point being harmed by the Quraysh wanting to kill him, and Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu anhu, he called out أتقتلون رجلا أن يقول ربي الله وقد جاءكم بالبينات. He said, are you going to kill a man just because he says, my Lord is Allah, and he came to you with proof upon proof that this is the truth, and there's no doubt in it. So they left him to go and then assault Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu. The way it was mentioned that time, his body was so hurt that even the hair was falling out of his head, from just calling out to warn them, as the Prophet ﷺ taught him. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, we have to really decide who we love more, Allah and His Messenger ﷺ or this dunya. We claim to love Allah, we claim to love His Messenger ﷺ more than anyone and anything else, but do we really? When tawheed is the staple, the foundation of this deen, when it's the foundation of our lives, when it is your salvation, yawm al-qiyamah, because you can come with all the prayers in the world, fasting every day, making hajj every year, making umrah every day, whatever you want to come with. But if your tawheed and your aqeedah are not correct, you're going to need something other than that cannot help you. There's no hope for you. So when that tawheed that the Prophet ﷺ came with, our ultimate salvation, but yet still, because of culture, because of ignorance, because of what we like, because of what we're used to, because of what mom and dad did or taught us, we won't get rid out of the ta'weez, the talismans, and the stuff around our necks, around our wrists, in our cars, in our homes. We won't get rid of those things because we belittle them. There's no belittling this. حَقَّ اللَّهُ عَلَى الْعِبَادِ أَن تَعْبُدُوا وَلَا تُشْرِكُوا بِهِ شَيْئًا. The Prophet ﷺ said, the right of Allah upon his slave is that you worship him and you do not associate any partners with him. The Anbiya came with the message, عُبُدُ اللَّهُ رَبِّي وَرَبُّكُمْ, worship your Lord, my worship Allah, your Lord and my Lord. And yet the Muslims who are on the purest thing on the face of this earth, tawheed, worshipping only one Lord at all times, not even associating partners with him in any way. Yet when this ummah gets ridiculed with shirk and it gets ignored, then we have a serious problem. How do you claim to love Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam when you allow shirk to persist in your homes? The salah, the first action you'll be asked about on the Day of Judgment. Something that in the last days of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when he was sick, when he was on his deathbed, he would keep saying, As-salah, as-salah, wa ma malakat aymanukum. As-salah, 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 as-salah. The prayer, the prayer, the prayer, the prayer. Emphasizing that salah. قَالَ قُلْ جُعْلَتْ قُرَّةَ عَيْنِي فِي الصَّلَاةِ. The beauty, the sweetness of my eyes, the coolness of my eyes has been placed in this prayer, in the salah. The salah, the action that the companions said and they agreed upon, if you leave it, you have left Islam, you're a Kafir, you're a disbeliever. The salah that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam himself said, "Man tarakaha faqad kafar." The one who leaves it has committed kufr. The one who leaves it has committed disbelief. How do we claim to love Allah's Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and we abandon the salah? We only do it when we're fasting Ramadan. The zakah, the greed that many of us have towards obligations that we should be paying, the sadaqah, the extra sadaqah we should be giving to help the ummah, especially the poor, the meek, the weak, the needy in them, to establish masajid, to establish schools for our children. قَالَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ إِنَّ لِكُلِّ أُمَّةٍ فِتْنَةٌ وَفِتْنَةُ أُمَّةِ الْمَالِ. The Prophet ﷺ, he said, every ummah was given a trial, a tribulation, a fitna. But the fitna of this ummah is wealth, is money. The fasting. The Prophet ﷺ said, كُتِبَ عَلَيْكُمُ الصِّيَامِ كَمَا كُتِبَ عَلَى الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. That the fasting was prescribed on you like it was on those before you, so you may achieve taqwa. So you may achieve a God consciousness, a reality that you keep your duty to Allah and you act in a way to put a barrier between yourself and Allah's punishment. The hajj, which many people delay, not because of things that come up in this, but they have amassed wealth, but they don't want to give up anything in their dunya and what they're chasing to go and make hajj. All of this. And we dare say we love the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. All of this. And we dare say we need to celebrate his life or his birthday or the likes of this. There's no true celebration of our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam's birth and life and message that he came with, except implementing the deen of Allah, following the Quran, acting upon the Quran, following the commands of the Prophet ﷺ, staying away from what he prohibited, doing what he said and did, avoiding what he warned us of, taking proof and evidence of this according to the lives and the implementation of the Sahaba radiallahu anhum, the companions of Allah, of Allah's Messenger ﷺ. Our Messenger ﷺ, كَانَ خُلْقُهُ الْقُرْآنِ, his character was the Qur'an. So fix yours and be as he was, and make your character the Qur'an. Where do we stand character-wise? If we say we love our Prophet ﷺ, and character and manners and morals and values and your behavior was stressed by him, كَمَا قَالْ مَا مِنْ شَيْءٍ أَثْقَلُ فِي الْمِيزَانِ مِنْ حُسْنِ الْخُلُقِ, that there is nothing heavier on your scales of good deeds on the day of resurrection than good behavior and good character. How do you claim to love the Messenger of Allah ﷺ when you're always around like an angry person? When you're always frowning? When you always want to treat people badly? When you're not kind? When you're not gentle with the people? When you look down on the people and you elevate yourself? How do you claim to love the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Enact his sunnah, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam. Good character, good treatment, especially to the family. كما قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم خيركم خيركم لأهله وأنا خيركم لأهلي وفي رواية خيركم خيركم لنسائهم. That the Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said, the best of you is the one who's best to his family, and I am the best to my family. As he said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and in the narration, the best of you is the one who's best to his wives or to his women. We have these proofs. And we have to also mention, this is also for the women. Because unfortunately, we're in a day and time where the women many times wear the pants in the relationship. Not that she just, you know, controls the household or whatever, but she abuses the husband and insults the husband and does not support the husband and ridicules the husband and threatens the husband. So this treatment of goodness to the family goes two ways. If you love Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, fix your character. Be good to the people. Be kind to the people. Be gentle with the people. The Muslim and the non-Muslim. Because Islam never spread by a sword. Islam wasn't threatened on the people. It spread because people knew that the tajar, the businessmen who were going to do business towards the east of Asia, they were honest and trustworthy. And it caught the attention of the people. The humility of the Muslim, the humbleness of the Muslim, the kindness of the Muslim, the gentleness of the Muslim, the forgivingness of the Muslim. This is what attracts people to Islam. This is what attracted people to Islam. So what are you doing to represent the character of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam? Look at these examples that we must know and point out that we clearly need legislation from Allah or His Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam to do things correctly. We don't have the knowledge. It's not a deen of intellect. It's a deen of athar. It's a deen of narration that we must follow. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he told us the best day of the week is Friday. And from the best deeds to do is to fast. Can you fast on the day of Friday? Most people would say, yeah, of course, that's the best fast of the week. And this is incorrect because our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he mana'a صوم يوم جمعة فقط يعني لحاله. He forbade the fasting of Friday by itself without combining a day with it. So we go back to the sunnah. Ali radiallahu anhu, he said, if the deen was intellect or knowledge, we'd wipe on the bottom of the sock, not on the top of the sock when we prepare for wudu. On top of this innovation, more sin and innovation is added, like calling upon him, calling upon the Prophet with prayers, with supplications, playing and singing music to honor him or about him. Qasidas from them, like Qasida Burda, a filthy home riddled with shirk upon shirk, calling upon the Prophet ﷺ, making dua to the Prophet ﷺ. His whole life was against that. And yet you have people doing this, claiming to be Muslim and loving him, and they're riddling their talk, their speech, their songs, their whatever they do with shirk, which is the opposite of tawheed. Even the kids know that. Yet it's being done day after day. Stand up for your tawheed, stand up for your Islam. Be brave, be bold. I don't care if it came from your culture. Who cares if you did it your whole life? I don't care if the people resent you. I don't care if they turn you out. Because our Prophet ﷺ, the companions, they led this ummah and they sacrificed all of that. even though their families turned them out, even though people ridiculed them and abused them physically, verbally, emotionally, mentally, psychologically, whatever you want to call it. Stand up for your tawheed. This is the biggest ni'mah, the biggest blessing you've been blessed with and you've been given. If you want to do something, then you look at what the Messenger of Allah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam did. What day was he born? On Monday. He said, "Fihi wulidtu wa fihi unzila alayya." He said, on Monday I was born, and on Monday the revelation was revealed to me, began to me. So, surely this is what we know. So out of gratitude to Allah, the Messenger of Allah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he fasted Mondays. So if you want to commemorate his birth and the revelation of the Quran, then implement the sunnah of fasting Mondays. And then you can do so. Ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu, he said, "Al-qasdu fi sunnah khayrun min ijtihadin fi bid'ah." Ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu, one of the greatest companions, knowing of what would happen with the people and deviating from the Quran and the sunnah, he said, the moderation with the sunnah, that you just do even some of the sunnah, is better than you taking a large effort to some innovation. And this is what we see the people doing. On the day of the Mawlid, or in that time, they'll get together to say 100,000 or 10,000, whatever, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and the likes of these matters. That large effort is not worth moderation in the sunnah. What did our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tell us? He told us, whoever says 10 times, did we say 1,000? Did we say 10,000? Did we say 100,000? We said 10 times. Why? Because the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said 10 times. Whoever says 10 times in the morning and 10 times in the evening, whoever says at those times, Allahumma salli wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad. May Allah send prayers and blessings on the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, or prayers and peace on the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they will obtain my shafa'a yawm al-qiyamah. Moderation in the sunnah is all that's needed of you. 10 times in the morning, 10 times in the evening. If you say, Allahumma salli wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad, then the Prophet ﷺ will intercede for you on your behalf by Allah's permission and ask Allah to forgive you for the major sins you did, for the major sins you committed, so that you may go to Jannah without any time in Jahannam. This is the deen we have that has specified how to purify ourselves in the restroom, how to take a bath, how to eat, how to sleep, how to drink, how to leave our homes, how to enter and leave our masajid, how to say, what to say on every occasion of living, when you have a dream, whether it's good or bad, when you wake up, when you go to sleep, when you eat, when the weather conditions are such, like we sent out on the WhatsApp when it was really windy, there's a dua for that. There's a dua for when it rains, a dua for when there's thunder, a dua for all of these things. Tasbih with your right hand, implement the sunnah. Saying Ameen out loud when the Imam says Ameen out loud. Because the Messenger of Allah on many narrations said that this was done. So say Ameen out loud, regardless of what you were taught. This is the proof from the Sunnah of Rasulullah, if you love him. Put the shoe on with your right foot. Take it off. Take off your shoe or your slipper with the left foot first. Leave off the dress and the haircuts he forbade for the men to not wear jewelry, to not wear silk, to not wear necklaces or bracelets or the likes of this. A ring which is silver or other than that, as long as it's not gold or white gold, a watch, this is okay. But other than that, we should not wear those aspects of jewelry because they're imitating the women. Not my words, from the sunnah of our Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, as explained by the ulama. Allah said, فَاسْأَلُوا أَهْلَ الذِّكْرِ إِن كُنْتُمْ لَا تَعْلَمُونَ. Ask the people of knowledge if you do not know. And many of us do not know. I myself, I do not know. We don't even reach the level of being a student of knowledge by the daily studies we do. So put your pride down, learn the deen of Allah so that you can implement it. So what are we saying? That somewhere along the line, we have all this way to live our life, but the mawlid of the Prophet ﷺ being celebrated was forgotten or missed? Then you're claiming that Allah neglected something from this deen, or He left us without some guidance. Wal'ayadu billah, we seek refuge with Allah from that evil thought. So even if you treat this as a doubtful matter, which there's no way in this earth you could see it as doubtful after all of these proofs and evidences. The Prophet ﷺ, he said, مَنْ وَقَعَ فِي الشُّبَهَاتِ وَقَعَ فِي الْحَرَامِ. So he said, whoever falls into doubtful matters falls into the haram. So leave it off, my brothers and sisters in Islam. From the Fatawa al-Lajna al-Da'ima, they said, honoring the Prophet and respecting him is by believing in what he came with from Allah. following his sunnah and the sharia and the aqidah, verbally and actively in character, and leaving off all innovation in the religion. And from those innovations is the celebration of his birth, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Aqulu qawli hadha wa astaghfirullah li wa lakum. Adu Allah yaghfir lakum dhunubakum. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه ونصلي ونسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا وبعد. My brothers and sisters in Islam, we always want a proof. We want to see proof for things. Look at how many people need to still be proven to take the vaccine, even though science has proved it. The ulama have said to take it, and they've taken it themselves, the scholars have. Yet, this is how we are. You have proof upon proof. Not to celebrate the birth of the Prophet ﷺ. You have proof upon proof that if you really love him and you want Allah to love you and you want to be forgiven for your sins and you want to be forgiven and granted Allah's mercy so you can get to Jannah, that you have to follow his sunnah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Proof upon proof. It's ridiculous how clear and plain it is. Yet shaitan has deviated so many of the minds, deceived so many of the people. Be of those who are the arduous followers of the Qur'an and the Sunnah, as it was revealed to Allah's Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and taught and implemented by his Sahaba radiallahu anhum wa ardahum. Loving the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is not by getting angry when someone makes a cartoon. It's not by having a protest or a riot or any of these things. It's not by harming people who quote unquote harm you. We go back to our Sunnah of our Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who said, for example, من قتل معاهد فلم يرح رائحة الجنة. Whoever takes the life of a non-Muslim who's living amongst the Muslims in peace and security, they may still hate you, but there's no peace and security in how there is peace and security. You're allowed to live there. There's no harm from them, even though they may hate you. Whoever takes the life of this mu'ahad, they will not smell from the fragrances of Jannah. And it is said that the fragrances of Jannah can be smelled for over 40 years of travel. From over 40 years of travel. Loving him, standing up for him is by implementing his sunnah. My brothers and sisters in Islam, so be firm on this. This is what we need to be doing and learning every day, not just one time a year, 1 week a year, 1 month a year. Because we are Muslims more than one day a year, bi-idhnillahi ta'ala. And we love our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. If we do like we say we do, then we should do it every day, not just one day out of the year. So this should be a constant clear message with us, that it is a heresy, an embarrassment, to mention and celebrate this day when our Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam didn't do so, nor his companions, nor the four imams, nor the first three generations from this ummah who were the best and who preceded us in that. Our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, لا تطروني كما أطرت النصارى ابن مريم. Do not worship me. Do not exaggerate in praising me. Do not exaggerate in honoring me like the Christians have the Son of Mary. And yet now, the Muslims at these other festivals besides those two Eids, namely the Mawlid or the birth of the Prophet ﷺ, you see them doing such to a grand scheme, sometimes even topping how some of the Christians do it towards the birth of Isa alayhi salam. It's sad when we don't follow our Prophet ﷺ and live this deen out according to the Quran and the Sunnah 365 days a year, as understood and lived by the Sahaba and the following two generations, radiallahu anhum wa ardahum. Allah says, وَمَنْ يُشَاقِقِ الرَّسُولِ مِنْ بَعْدِ مَا تَبَيَّنَ لَهُ الْهُدَى وَيَتَّبِعْ غَيْرَ سَبِيلِ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ نُوَلِّيهِ مَا تَوَلَّى وَنُصْلِهِ جَهَنَّمْ وَسَاءَتْ مَصِيرًا. Allah says what means in Surah Al-Nisa, and whoever contradicts or opposes the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam after the right path has clearly been shown to him, and follows other than the believer's way, we shall keep him in the path he has chosen, and burn him in Jahannam. What an evil destination. Our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said that this ummah would divide, and people would deviate, and to 73 different groups. Wallahu a'lam. He said, 72 in the hellfire, one of them in Jannah. He said, ma ana alayhi al-yawm wa ashabi, clarifying al-jama'ah. He said, what I am upon today, and what my companions are upon. There's no need for anyone or anything else after the sunnah has been made clear to us. قال الله لقد كان لكم في رسول الله أسوة حسنة لمن كان يرجو الله اليوم الآخر وذكر الله كثيرا. Allah says what means indeed in the Messenger of Allah, Muhammad ibn Abdullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you have a good example to follow for him who hopes in the meeting with Allah and the last day, and he remembers Allah much. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, we follow the sunnah of our beloved Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, perform the actions he did and refuse to worship Allah with actions he did not perform. From them, this celebrating of the Mawlid of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We follow the four rightly guided khulafa in best in order after the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Abu Bakr as-Siddiq, Umar ibn al-Khattab, Uthman ibn Affan, Ali ibn Abi Talib, radiallahu anhum wa ardahum. They never celebrated the Mawlid. As the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, وَعَلَيْكُمْ بِسُنَّةِ وَسُنَّةِ الْخُلَفَاءِ الرَّاشِدِينَ الْمَهْدِيِينَ مِنْ بَعْدِي. Upon you is the is my sunnah and the sunnah of the four rightly guided khulafa after me. We follow the other companions of the Prophet ﷺ, those who were closest to him, who loved him, who followed him, who took everything from him, even if it meant their life. They did not celebrate the mawlid of the Prophet ﷺ. The four great Imams of Ahl Sunnah, Imam Abu Hanifa, Imam Malik, Imam Shafi'i, Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal, Rahimahumullah ta'ala, none of them ever celebrated the Mawlid of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We follow 400 years of early Muslims, the most pious of generations, the greatest of scholars who never celebrated the Mawlid of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We believe that the action of celebrating the Mawlid, without a doubt, is a bid'ah. And this is coming from the scholars, the ulama, based on proofs and evidences, and every innovation is religion, in the religion is rejected. مَنْ عَمَلَ عَمَلًا لَيْسَ عَلَيْهِ أَمْرُنَا فَهُوَ رَدْ. Whoever does, speaks, acts in a way that was not legislated by Allah and His Messenger ﷺ, it should be rejected. We take our Prophet ﷺ as our role model, as the best of mankind, the one to follow, not this actors or actresses, rappers or musicians, whatever it may be, sports athletes, all these people we've begun to idolize and put above the best of mankind. If you want to meet Allah and you yearn for it, and you want to meet Allah on the last day and you yearn for it, and you remember Allah much, then you're a person whose role model should only be the Messenger of Allah, Muhammad ibn Abdullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, be firm to this. You're not the one causing the problem if you're firm on the haq. Be firm to it. You want to love the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and maybe this time where people say it's his birth comes around, and you want to, you know, put yourself straight, then say, you know what, I'm going to learn a hadith today and memorize it, and implement it. I'm going to learn a dhikr today and say it. Remember, 10 times in the morning and the evening, Allahumma salli wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad. If you say that 10 in the morning, 10 in the evening, that's it. Not 100, 10,000, 100,000, whatever. That moderation in the sunnah, guess what? You will have his shafa'ah on the day of resurrection by Allah's permission. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allahumma akhir lil muslimin wal muslimat wal mu'minin wal mu'minat al ahya'i minhum wal amwat innaka anta sami'un qareeb al mujib al da'wat ya muqallib al qulub thabbit quluban ala deenik ya muqallib al qulub thabbit quluban ala deenik ya muqallib al qulub thabbit quluban ala deenik allahumma salli wa sallim ala nabiyyina muhammad اللهم صل وسلم على نبينا محمد اللهم صل وسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين ومن اتبعوهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين وصلى الله على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين.